Hey and welcome to the Skippy Guide on Tsukuba 2K. This is one of the tracks which is easy to learn but hard to master. That's why you will find two setups in the database this week. There's the one I drove the lab with, which has a snappy and loose rear. Usually I try to build the setups on the safer side, but this week there's no way around it because the snappy rear helps you a lot to get the car around the tight hairpins. If you have a hard time with it, you can try a second one, which is safer but also slightly slower around the slow corners. I will leave the choice up to you, and as always you can find all files in the database on Discord. Let's dive into the lab. Be prepared to cover the inside, every hairpin offers an opportunity for attacks. If there's nobody around you, you want to approach the turn on the outside and use the wall behind the fence on the left as marker for braking. Get ready to countersteer, because the car will become unstable when you pass the small crest which leads to the turn. Your goal for the turn is to hit a late apex, which allows you to be early on the throttle. This applies to every hairpin on this track, which means you will have many opportunities to practice the line. At first you want to turn in while you are still on the brakes and decelerate deep into the turn. As you can see here, we are approaching the apex of the corner and are still quite far away from the inside of the turn, but the car is already set up for the exit. That's the key which allows you to hit the throttle early and carry more speed onto the short straight. Get close to the curb when you are exiting and don't forget to use all available space on the exit. Don't worry if you think that you have not understood every detail. As mentioned before, this line is a repeating pattern and we will see it two more times. The marker for the next turn is the change of the track surface. Approach the turn on the outside, hit the brakes hard and decelerate deep into the corner again. You want to turn the car and leave some space on the inside like in turn 1. Engage the throttle early and exit along the curb on the inside. Ideally, there is no long period of coasting between braking and accelerating again. Position the car on the outside and if you got the confidence and speed, you should shift into third gear. It does make a small difference on the exit compared to staying in second. Lift slightly while turning in and attack the curb on the inside. You want to be on this curb. The further you attack it, the more speed you will be able to carry onto the short straight. The exit can be tricky, especially on cold tires, so be careful with your throttle inputs during the first laps. Later on, you can take this exit flat out. The marker for the last hairpin is the green curb on the left side. Hit the brakes and you already know what's coming up. Approach the turn on the outside. Get the car turned, pull back to the inside. Engage the throttle early and use all available space on the exit. At first it will feel like it's easy to lose the rear in the last turn, but in reality it's impossible if you mind one thing. Never turn in while you are still engaging the brakes. The setup is optimized for the hard braking zones and tight turns. Trail braking in a high speed turn is the worst thing you could do. The car will immediately spin and there's no chance to recover. That's why you want to look out for the yellow barriers on the left, tap the brakes when you are alongside them and downshift into third gear. Lift, turn in from the outside and aim for a wide and smooth line. Get back on the throttle once you feel that the car is stable and accelerate towards the finish line. Make sure you avoid the curb on the inside, it's steep and will slow you down. And, as usual, don't forget to use all available space on the exit. That's it. Have fun with the cockpit lab which is coming up next. Thanks for your support here on YouTube, Twitch, Patreon and thanks for watching. I wish you good luck for the next week and see you next time.